Hello and welcome back to Makeshift Minis.
I was scrounging around Thingiverse again and I found a couple of knight models. I decided to go with a pair of them, a Shining Paladin and a Wicked Blackguard. STLs will be in the description. After downloading and slicing the files, it's time to print. The knights are very solid models, so the supports come off with little issue. There's a little bit of cleanup to do afterwards with my knife, but not all that much. Make sure they stick to the base, I lightly sand the knights and the bases. PLA is slick and it needs a bit of roughing up to make sure the glue holds. With the prep work out of the way, I glued the minis to their bases. At this point, my formula for detailed minis is pretty obvious. Prime in gray and then base coat it black. As it turns out, a hairdryer really helps make paint dry quickly. Once the base coat's dry, I give the minis a quick dry brush of gray. There's something magical of just watching the details come out when you dry brush white. The first mini I work on is the Paladin. I start by painting most of his armor, sword, and shield a brilliant silver. Using a bit of gold, I pick out the armor panels that I left unpainted. So, as it turns out, I didn't get footage of me painting his cape purple, which is annoying. However, I did get footage of painting the Paladin's sleeves and pants a rich blue. The Paladin's tabard is painted white. I'm actually quite surprised in how well the undercoat showed through. Aside from a few other details, the last color I use is brown when I paint the belt and sword handle. Since black tends to overwhelm the undercoat, to get the Death Knight's armor a nice dark color, I use a very dark gray. I have to be very careful when painting it, but it does get me close to the color I want. The axe, chains, and a few other details get painted silver. I happen to like metallics paint since I don't have to thin them, and that involves a lot of guesswork. A couple of details are painted gold, like the back of the axe and the crown. I always find dark undercoats work very nicely for gold. I mix yellow and an off-white to get a nice ivory color for the Death Knight's skull mask and his left knee. Using a fine brush, I paint the jewels on his right shoulder red. The shaft of the axe gets a couple of coats of brown paint. The off-white goes on the hair very nicely, but I do have to make a few touch-ups afterwards. To dull down the brighter colors of the metallics and add more shading to the recesses, I give the Death Knight a dark wash. I probably could have gotten away with not putting any on the armor since it's barely noticeable given how dark it is. With both minis done, I paint the bases black. Once the paint dries in a clear coat, it's onto the glamour shots. Both of these minis came out really well. They weren't that hard to paint, and honestly, if I had the room, I'd happily have an army of each. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment down below. Take care, be well, and until next time.